This tutorial shows how to test the assumption of homogeneity of variances for the mixed ANOVA and SPSS. Homogeneity of variances means that the variances across the groups are the same at all times. In other words, the variances for the test variable of the groups are compared at each point in time. Initially, an eye test can be helpful. I can have the standard deviation, i.e. the square root of the variance, output via the mixed ANOVA when requesting descriptive statistics within it. Alternatively, I will briefly show you how you can request the variances directly with just a few more clicks. First, go to Data, Split File, and select Organize Output by Groups, and put the group variable in the field below that says Groups Based On. Please be aware that this change should be undone after the variances have been calculated. Now, go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies. The values for the measurements are moved into the variables box here. As we do not need frequency tables, we uncheck the box accordingly. Under the Statistics button, the variance is requested at the bottom left in the Dispersion section. Now let's look at the output. The first group is at the top, the second at the bottom, showing the variances at the respective points in time accordingly. The variances should be roughly similar between the groups for each time point. There are no problems in my example for T4 and T5. The differences in T1 to 3 are slightly above the still acceptable difference of 10 to 20% though. However, it should be pointed out that homogeneity of variances is not a mandatory requirement for equal or very similar group sizes. See Field 2018, page 259. It is also negligible for large samples. If a Levene's test has to be performed, it can also be output with the mixed ANOVA. However, a warning needs to be issued. The Levene's test, like any other analytical test, is prone to be misleading depending on the sample size. It is oversensitive for large samples, but also not sensitive enough for small samples. If you really need to report it, don't forget to reset the split calculations and split output defined earlier before doing the calculation. Go through Analyze, General Linear Model Repeated Measures. The within subject vector name and its number of levels need to be defined first. Then, the within subject variables and between subjects factor are then assigned accordingly. Under Options, check Homogeneity Tests and perform the calculation by clicking Next and OK. The Levene's test can be found a little further down, and there are different versions for each point in time. The standard test is based on the mean value. However, the more robust version based on the median should be preferred. The significance column is decisive here. Small values, usually below 0.05 or 0.01, lead to the rejection of the null hypothesis of equality of variances. If you have a larger sample, you can use the above reasoning to lower the alpha to 0.001 and test that way. But I emphasize again, the Levene's test is not recommended, and I have only shown it for the sake of showing it, in case reviewers, despite its problems, insist on having it reported. In my case, according to Levene's test, I'm lucky and have equal variances in my groups for each time point. If there is a larger difference in the variances at one or only 2 points in time, this is not keeping you from doing the mixed ANOVA. If there are different variances in the majority of time points, a transformation of the test variable can help. I can now continue with the mixed ANOVA or check the other assumptions.